everyone, welcome to SST College of Arts and Commerce. This is SST Edupedia and I am Assistant Professor Neha Delani. We have already started economics subject in last lecture and in that we have covered meaning and features of microeconomics. In today's lecture, we are going to cover meaning and features of macroeconomics. But before going for macroeconomics, let's revise what microeconomics is. Now, basically, in economics, there are two branches, micro and macroeconomics. And both these terms were coined by economist Regnar Frisk in 1933. Micro and macroeconomics, both are derived from Greek words. Micro is derived from Greek word micros, which means small or a millionth part. And macro is derived from Greek word means macro, sorry, micro meaning large. And microeconomics means what? Micro means small or a part of a thing. Microeconomics deals with small part of national economy. It studies the behavior of individual units such as individual consumer, individual producer, price of a product. In microeconomics, we consider the partial study as we consider only the individual units and not the aggregates, not the total units and not the total. That is, for example, here I consider the national income of individual person in microeconomics. When I study about or regarding a particular tree, that study will be classified under microeconomics. So here we are considering only individual units. Now let's understand meaning of macroeconomics in this particular video. Microeconomics is a branch of economics that analyzes the entire economy. Here I am considering the entire economy and not the part or a individual unit as we have studied in micro. Macroeconomics deals with total employment, it deals with national income, it deals with national output, total investment, total consumption, total saving, inflation, trade cycle, business cycles, all these are covered under macroeconomics. Thus, microeconomics is study of aggregates or study of total. Now let's understand features of microeconomics. The first feature of macroeconomics is study of aggregates. Microeconomics deals with study of aggregates. It deals with the study of economy as a whole. Here I am not studying the individual units like we have studied in microeconomics, like study of individual tree, study of income of individual person. Here I am considering the entire economy. For example, when I study the entire forest, so entire forest, study of entire forest is covered under macroeconomics. When I study the national income, national income will be covered under macroeconomics, because here we study the entire economy and not the branch of that economy. So the concepts such as national income, national output, national employment, general price level, business cycles, fluctuations in the market, all these things are covered under macroeconomics. Next feature of macroeconomics is income theory. Microeconomics helps the microeconomics explain the causes or fluctuations in the national income. Why the national income fluctuates and how it leads to business cycles, like how the inflation happens, how the deflation happens in the economy, that all is studied under macroeconomics. So macroeconomics studies the basic concepts like national income, that is, we study the different methods of measurement of national income, etc. Third feature of macroeconomics is general equilibrium analysis. In microeconomics, we have studied that microeconomics deals with partial equilibrium analysis. Why? Because there we study only the individual units, we study only the part of the economy and not the entire economy. But as in macroeconomics, we study the entire economy, so it deals with behavior of large aggregates. It deals with the behavior of like general equilibrium, like behavior of aggregate demand, aggregate supply, price in the whole economy. That's why it is general equilibrium analysis. In general, we have analysis of each and everything, like what will be the aggregate demand, what will be the aggregate supply, what will be the general price, etc. Next feature of microeconomics is interdependence. Microeconomics takes into account the interdependence between aggregate economic variables. There are economic variables like income, output, employment, investment, price level, and all these variables are interdependent. For example, if there is change in level of investment, it will finally result into change in the level of income, change in level of output, change in level of employment, and eventually there will be change in level of economic growth, because all these variables are interdependent, interrelated with each other. Next feature of microeconomics is lumping method. In microeconomics, we have studied that microeconomics deals with slicing method, because there we study only the partial things and not the aggregates. So partial, that means we divide entire economy and split into small parts. So that is what slicing method. But here macroeconomics deals with lumping method, as we study the whole economy rather than its part. For example, forest is an aggregation of trees, but it does not reveal the properties of individual tree. Here I am not considering the individual tree, but here I am considering the entire forest. So that's what we are having, this lumping method over here. This reveals the difference between micro and macroeconomics. Like in microeconomics, we go for slicing method, and macroeconomics deals with lumping method. Next is growth model. Growth model, now there are various growth model or economic that are necessary for the study of economic development. Microeconomics studies the various factors that contribute to the economic growth and development. The growth models are established or they are developed so that we can have overall development, we can study the economic development of the nation. Next is general price level. Now macroeconomics determine, and it also indicates or highlights the changes in general price level. General price level means what? General price level means average of all prices of goods and services currently being produced in the economy. In entire economy, in an year, how much goods and services are produced and how the pricing of that particular products are being that is fixed, that is studied under macroeconomics. Next is policy oriented. Now macroeconomics is policy oriented science. It suggests the various policies. It tries to formulate or it tries to maintain the various policies which are necessary to promote economic growth, to generate employment, to control inflation and depression in the economy, etc. So macroeconomics helps to establish or helps to lay down the various policies which are very helpful or which are very necessary for overall economic development of the nation. So these are certain features of macroeconomics. Thank you.